3 months since Katie's heartbreaking split with Pete.
I don't even think about Pete not being there. I just don't bother.
But she's bouncing back. 3 months, Katie! Busier than ever.
Please welcome Katie Price.
Katie Price, welcome to the West Country Tonight.
Boys, the Pricey is back!
For the last 2 weeks, she's been dating new man Alex.
Oh, my goodness.
And enjoying a blossoming romance.
Missionary. You don't know who you're going to fall for, when, how.
This week, marriage is in the air again.
Love this. I want it.
This is crazy. I've never been more honest with anybody in my entire life.
But preparations are thrown into chaos.
Oh, my God, can you turn the camera up?
She has to keep an eye on her man.
I hear what the ladies have asked you, Alex.
I can't help it. I'm drop-dead gorgeous.
And it's all too much for Katie.
She broke down. It was all a bit teary.
I felt that I was a failure, because when you marry somebody, you marry them for life. And mine wasn't for life.
Marriage may be the last thing on Katie's mind, but today, wedding bells are in the air. Next week, she's the maid of honour as friends Gary and Phil renew their wedding vows. So, she's out shopping for the perfect dress.
You are gorgeous. Mummy loves you so much. Mummy does.
Hello.
What about something like this?
The ceremony will mark a watershed for Katie, as not only will it evoke memories of her own wedding day, but it will also stir up the raw emotion she's felt since her marriage ended. And with the paparazzi sending a possible wedding exclusive, the shutters are brought down to stop them getting a sneak preview of her outfit.
How exciting.
I don't like this one on me. Well, that you can sort of see, Gary, what you think it's like. That's that one.
So with high heels.
Well, this.
I prefer that to you. I do think it's gorgeous.
But what's the other option? That one, and then what other one?
This one, the wedding one in the window.
It's 4 years since Katie walked down the aisle at her own wedding, and as the maid of honour, she'll be making that emotional journey again. Her fairy tale marriage may be over, but with the theme of Gary's ceremony being a Midsummer Night's Dream, she's got another chance to wear a magical dress.
That's going to be the fairy tale one.
That is nice. That is totally, and because it is fairy tale, that totally makes sense.
Hey, because it's fairy tale, it's what it makes sense. It's Cinderella.
See, I actually prefer a lot of these dresses to her own wedding dress.
Good eye. This is the one.
The dress has been designed exclusively for the shop Dolly, as was the outfit Katie wore when she renewed her vows to Pete.
Love this. I want it.
Why
can't I get married in it? I like this. It's really fairy tale. Look at the way that glistens, Gary.
Yeah, it is magical.
This one is, isn't it?
What, with the tiara?
Yeah.
She thinks she's trying to steal the show.
What are you wearing? You're going to look like Versace.
Well, does it matter what I wear? Does it matter what I wear?
They so should have done my wedding dress.
That's better than your wedding dress you had.
I know.
It's gorgeous.
So this, look at that little train on the back. I love it.
She may not have a groom to wow in her wedding dress, but she does have new boyfriend Alex to impress. The ceremony will be their first public appearance as a couple.
Kate's new boyfriend, that sounds really weird. I can't get used to that. I'm going to have to, though, aren't I? So Alex is definitely coming, and I think, you know, should be interesting, I think.
Can we try this one?
Yeah.
The heavy dress there is what she's going after now. It's massive, and it's heavy as hell.
Oh, my God. Feel how heavy that is. That is unbelievable. So is this all Swarovski crystal?
All Swarovski. It's all handmade.
That is, like, superstar dress.
Oh, wow. It's just a bit too long at the front. Is there any way I could have it taken up? Or just hook it up?
Yeah. We'll not think about the wig.
Wow.
That is fantastic.
Isn't it?
Wow. The jewellery.
That is absolutely stunning.
That is stunning.
I love it. I'm excited now. It's something new. If this isn't very Gary or me, then I don't know what is.
Well, Gary, is that not good for you?
Well, you know, we could have a little bit more just there.
Perfect. Love that.
That means two dresses now.
Katie's made her choices.
It's got my dresses.
And she's clearly a woman with expensive taste.
£17,400 is a wedding dress. £22,000 is a silver.
See, if I don't feel special in a dress, that amount of money, there's something wrong. Yeah. But the fact is, any of your dresses, I just love them all. Love them. And when I get married again, I will be wearing one of your dresses.
Bye, princess.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank
you. Oh, I love that
kiss.
Thank you.
Having negotiated the loan of the £39,000 wedding dresses, the shopping's been a real success. It's a new day, and Katie's about to take delivery of an even bigger purchase. In true Katie style, it's pink, state-of-the-art, and a must-have for every horse-loving glamour model. Why, of course, it's a £120,000 custom-made horse box.
Wow, that
looks fab. It does, actually. I love that glitter. I love it. That is wicked.
Absolutely stunning.
I am the most spoiltest girl ever on the planet. Oh, I love it. I love it. Oh, I love it.
Katie seems to, love it. And with a weekend away planned with Alex, she's checking its fit for purpose.
You have to be very cosy when you're up here doing the actual thing, I think. Wait, let's have a look.
You have to do the bottom one instead,
just
actually.
Just having a look. Yeah. Missionary. The horses. No, how much fun we're going to have in this.
Katie can't wait to get behind the wheel, so after a quick tour, she's off for a spin.
Mum, are you getting in? Just get in, Mum. We're all in it.
Mum,
come on.
I'm not going to smash my lorry up, am I? Just get in. Now. Get in.
I'm frightened. I'll watch you. I'll watch you.
See you later, then.
It's the first time Katie's driven her new 25-foot, 7.5-ton lorry. And it's a fact not missed by the anxious horse box salesman.
Stop. Say stop.
I am quite good at things like this.
Right, slow down.
Just get that away.
Right.
No cars in that way.
Right, keep using your mirrors. Sir.
What are you nervous about?
I'm all right.
Trust me, I'm a good driver.
I believe you.
Well, it's quite easy to drive.
Just watch it going in here.
Move your cars.
Take a good swing at it.
Yeah, yeah.
Trust
me, I'll be
fine. Watch that bollard there.
I'll be absolutely fine. Trust me.
Katie. It's open.
All right, none of you panic.
Whoa.
Didn't you look panic?
I don't want to scratch it.
Never panic. Mission accomplished.
Back in one piece.
Absolutely.
Test drive over. Katie, her new horse box, and even the paparazzi are still in one piece. Coming up, new boyfriend Alex is falling head over heels.
We connect on so many different levels. It's just unreal.
Katie's hit by wedding nerves.
The fact that I'm in a bigger, better dress than my wedding dress, but walking down the aisle with no man to meet at the end. Nah, that's not weird, is it?
Before disaster strikes.
Oh my God, can you turn the camera up? My veneer's come out. I need to find a dentist, I'm not joking.
It's morning at the Price household, and Katie's new boyfriend, cage fighter Alex Reed, has spent the night. They may have only been together 3 weeks, but things are moving fast and he's more smitten than ever.
It's pretty amazing. It's been very whirlwindy these last few weeks. Here I am, standing semi-naked in the kitchen.
While Katie gets ready for the day ahead upstairs, Alex is making himself at home.
Yes, I've been very much enjoying hanging out with Kate recently. We've We connect on so many different levels. It's just unreal. It's just crazy. It's like I've never been more honest with anybody in my entire life. She knows everything about me. It's like interesting to see the real Katie behind all of the glamour and the smile she puts on when she's in front of the camera for, you know, the real Katie is amazing.
Bye. See ya.
Have a good day.
Bye.
But with the kids off to Pete's, unloved up Alex is left behind as Katie heads off with publicist Diana. They're setting off on the latest stage of the book tour to publicise Katie's fourth novel, which was released last week. And the publicity push is certainly paying off.
So I'm really chuffed that I got number one, because, you know, I've had all this bad shit press for the past 3 months. And it just goes to prove it that I've still got my fans there, and thank God for that.
This week, she's visiting Southwest England. And first up is Bristol, the sixth stop on her punishing nationwide book tour, and it's starting to take its toll.
I don't feel sick when I'm just tired. I'm just not with it.
But Katie's got no choice. She must plough on as the crowd at her book signing is growing fast.
Hey! Oh, it feels so rough.
And as the crowds begin to enter the bookshop, backstage, Katie's thoughts turn to Pete.
Pete never come on my book tour, it's very rare. It's separate. A lot of stuff I did separate from Pete anyway. It was Pete who done a lot of stuff with me. So, I know this is really harsh to say, but I don't even think about Pete not being ill. I just don't bother. I'm in the new chapter, new beginning. He's just like Dwight now, just there, father the kids, see the kids when you want. We've got our own lives, separate lives.
Indeed, Katie's now got a far weightier issue on her mind.
I've just had a massive jacket potato, knowing I'm going to get in the most tightest outfit ever with a tutu, and there's no way I'm not wearing it without a tutu today. I've got cellulite dimples on my legs for this week.
So, one tight change of clothes later, Katie's ready to meet her adoring public. First of all, a glamorous TV interview.
Katie Price, welcome to the West Country Tonight. Good to see you.
Thank you, and it's good to be here.
Before the signings begin.
I love you, Katie!
Nearly 1,000 fans have turned up, but with Katie feeling increasingly under the weather, it's proving a real struggle.
Yeah, I just don't feel that well. Thanks. Jazz. I'm just feeling a bit achy. But show must go on.
We love
Hiya. You. Thank you for coming. Thank you very much.
Finally, with everything and everyone signed, Katie calls it a day.
It's really, really good. I've signed about 900 and something copies. It's just that I don't feel well at all. I really don't feel well.
Now it's off for an early night as Katie tries to regain her strength ahead of another day of book signings. But the following morning in Bournemouth, she's not feeling any better.
I feel the same as yesterday, really. I woke up once in the night. But it'll be fine.
But one thing lifting her spirits is Gary's wedding, which is now just a week away.
I can't wait to wear my dress.
Can't wait to see you in it.
Honestly, I can't wait. Fuck the fact that it's Gary's wedding vows, I get to be in a big dress again. I love it. And I've got no commitment, no attachment to anyone. I could just wear that dress, walking down an aisle. Perfect. Bloody hell, I'll be walking down an aisle.
I know.
Last time
Will
I did
feel
that.
Will that feel weird?
Nah. But the fact that I'm in a bigger, better dress than my wedding dress, but I'm walking down the aisle with no man to meet at the end. Nah, that's not weird, is it?
Well, one thing you can always be sure of, you've got me and Phil. And
exactly.
We'll always be there.
Exactly, so. Exactly.
With Gary applying the finishing touches...
Oh, no, you've let the secret out. She doesn't wear false eyelashes, does she? Really?
Katie heads off to her latest book signing, where the anticipation of her arrival is reaching fever pitch.
We want Katie!
but the baying crowd may be in for a wait.
You've got a chewing gum these times. I can't do my signing.
Why?
My veneer's come out. I need to find a dentist. I'm not joking.
Oh,
the air's getting to it. I've just lost another bloody veneer. I'm late for my signing and I'm not doing it, so I've got my veneer here. And I haven't chewed it.
Hi. Really weird call. I'm just on in Bournemouth on the way to a signing with Katie Price, and one of her veneers has come off of her teeth, one of her teeth.
I haven't broken
so
yet.
I need an emergency dentist like 5 minutes ago. I can just stick it on.
Always a bloody drama, isn't it, Gary?
It's not that bad. I mean, you can't do it. You've got to get it stuck on, but...
I can't believe I've got a signing to do. There's hundreds of people waiting and my tooth is falling out.
God, Kate.
And with a queue of over 800 people growing by the minute, Diana begins a desperate search.
Oh, hi, is that an emergency dentist? We desperately need an emergency dentist to stick it back on.
Because we're already 20 minutes late. There's about, literally about 1,000 people waiting for her.
I didn't pay all that money for a set of teeth to be fucked.
I urgently need a dentist to stick on a veneer. I really don't mind how much it costs. It's Katie Price, but obviously that's confidential.
With Diana struggling, Katie's appearance at the book signing is under serious threat.
Victoria, I'm sorry, complete dramas. I've been ringing round loads of emergency numbers for dentists in Bournemouth and I can't find one anywhere. I know, but she can't do it without a tooth. Liz, well, yeah, she's given me a couple of numbers. Sorry, hold on 1 second. I've just got a call coming in. I'll ring you back.
But with the book signing on the verge of being cancelled...
Fantastic. Thank you. Great. Thank you. Okay, bye.
Well, I can't keep him waiting in the queue, can I?
Well, you could.
Minutes later, Katie arrives at the dentist.
Thanks very much.
And despite the drama, it seems to be good news for the Bournemouth fans.
So we're still going to the signing, but we're going to be about 2 hours late. But they all know and they're all very happy to wait.
However, there's another problem.
Burner! The drama is, I do have to have a needle to numb my mouth, which means my smile will be distorted. So now I don't know what to do.
If we don't use the anaesthetic,
yep.
The bond's not going to be quite as
right.
Good, which means it may fall off.
Okay. Why don't have it done properly
and then see how you feel?
Sometimes it affects it a lot,
and it won't here.
It will be bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to have a lot of
sight
and smile.
Oh no, I just don't want a needle.
I'll be gentle.
Right, I will ring them.
Just a small prick.
I'm used to that.
So, despite best efforts, Katie won't be making the signing after all. And the news of the postponement has started filtering back to the expectant crowd.
I don't know, I'm just so disappointed, to be honest with you, really disappointed.
Everyone was waiting for like 4 hours, but some people at the start was waiting for eight.
I'm a new Katie Price, obviously I'm here, I won't let you down, don't worry.
Katie's fans are understandably frustrated, but she's made the right decision.
Already Rob says she's like that.
Hello. She's thinking of a notice, haven't you?
Is Diana cancelling the...?
Yeah, I think she's on the phone at the moment, cancelling, rearranging for next weekend.
Next weekend?
Yeah.
She can't do next weekend. She's got a wedding to go to.
What's my point?
She can't do next weekend.
Where is she?
After a traumatic half hour in the dentist's chair, the agony is finally over.
I'm not even looking. Thanks very much, guys.
No, I'm glad we could help. I'm sorry, I've
cancelled
your day.
It's fine. Thank you. Thanks very much. I'll see you later. Take care. Thank you. Bye.
See you.
Thank you. I'm going home. I don't feel well anyway, and that's just topped it up. I've got the shakes from the injections, and I just want to go home. Sorry if I've let anyone down.
She's not well. The lashes have come off. That's the sign.
Coming up, there's nowhere to hide.
Well, lucky I'm in the studio here anyway.
Excuse me, mate.
Sorry.
Hi. Not Ben Cheese.
Katie's hit by wedding jitters.
This actually is very weird, isn't it?
Weird.
Before she's overwhelmed by the emotion of the big day. It's 5 days since Katie's dental emergency, and having now recovered from the flu, she's ready to return to work. She's in London for a photo shoot and to record a song for Gary and Phil's wedding.
It's quite handy because my shoot here I'm doing today with my underwear, and opposite is where I've got to go to the studio. So that's pretty handy. And there's Denny. Ah, we'll stop there. There's Denny.
Katie will be laying down the vocals with Denny, her record producer.
Denny! Denny!
Run to the window.
I have to have you listen to it before I keep going.
Okay, lucky I'm in the studio here anyway.
Excuse me, mate, do you mind?
Just let us have a... What an idiot that guy was. Knobbing cheese. Have you got the backing track? I'll just give it to Denny.
Yeah.
And the words and everything. Cool.
All right, well, I'll pop
Thanks,
over.
Denny.
Bye.
See ya. Look at him. Run. You better get the shot because you might miss it, boys. What a shame.
First stop is the photo shoot, and as Gary gets Katie prepared, she's keen Andy the photographer is ready to get snapping.
Is all your lighting done, Andy? Ready to chop, chop, chip?
I'm ready.
We're not going to have too many people poking their noses in, are we? Saying we want it like this, that. Excellent. Just thought I'd clarify that.
Nobody's watching, we're just going.
Wicked.
Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am.
Love it.
That's it.
That's how we like to work.
That's how we do it.
Today's shoot for Asda has a pink theme as it's part of a breast cancer awareness campaign. And with hair and makeup done, Katie meets a stylist to decide her first outfit.
I'm all yours. Yes, I don't think the viewers at home want to see my pot face sticking out my scar tits, do you?
The first dress fails to hit the mark.
This dress is a no-no. See, I'm not put on weight. Gross. Are you ready, Andy?
But she soon finds something more to her taste.
Oh, my God.
Shut up and just shoot it, Andy.
That does it for me.
Yeah, it really does it for me, too. I'm the quickest person I've ever worked with once I'm ready. It takes me all day to get ready.
Very nervous. Could you do the side-on one again, please?
Yeah. Don't ever tell me what to do, Andy.
Done. Thank you. Perfect. All done and dusted. Everything went according to plan. Got some nice pictures, so I think she's happy. The clients are very happy, and going home now.
Thanks, Ben. Give us a call later. I'm not going to kiss anyone because I've got the lurgy. Oh, bye. See you in a minute.
But Katie's day isn't over as she heads next door to the music studio.
Hey.
Hello.
I'm here. Late because I've been working.
You're always late, whether you're working or not.
I know. Right, this song is DJ Sammy Heaven. I'm going to sing it at Gary and Phil's wedding. There's lots of people singing at their wedding, like proper diva, like proper singers. And me, yet again, set myself a challenge to try and sing a song. But luckily, this is a nice key for me. It's not uncomfortable, I'm not straining. And, well, I haven't recorded it yet.
The sentimental ballad is one of Katie's all-time favourite songs.
We're in heaven. It's not that bad, is it?
Right key and everything.
Perfect key.
Katie's vocal cords are now warmed up.
Out.
And not wanting to ruin the surprise of her singing before the wedding itself, she throws out the cameras. It's early the next morning at Shea Price and the kids are back from Pete's.
Wow. Hello. Are you gorgeous? Are you? Did you miss me?
Did you?
Oh! I've just woken up. Didn't get in till 2:30, 3, because I was recording a song for Gary's wedding last night. Took ages. And the kids weren't due back till 6 o'clock, and I said, if Pete's working, can they come back early so I've got the day with them? Hey, you!
Hey!
Oh, so you want some pretties on?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
Mom. Can I get your banana?
Hello. Hello.
And with Gary and Phil's wedding now just a few days away, Katie's in reflective mood about the breakup of her own marriage.
Any people out there knows when you split up, you have to share the kids and that's it. So when Pete has the kids, I go away and do whatever I want to do or work. In fact, it's perfect. My mum and dad split when I was probably about junior's age. I can't remember, it hasn't affected me. I can see my dad when I like. Everyone's friends, there's no dramas. I'm used to this split up, it's so... I've been there and done it myself, so... But life goes on, you can't just stay together just because of the kids. And I wouldn't stay with someone just because of the kids. Yeah, I'm divorcing, I'm single. Well, I'm not single, I'm seeing Alex now. But, you know, big deal, it happens to hundreds of people out there.
And with the kids in tow, Katie's heading off to complete some unfinished business.
I'm going to Bournemouth now to do my book signing. It's my turn to have the kids, so obviously they have to come with me, and which is fine. But normally I would have taken them out for the day, but I've had to go back to redo it because I couldn't do it last week.
And boyfriend Alex is there to see them off.
Sorry.
I'm not
coming today.
We'll see him later. You're going to see loads of girls and boys.
I'm going to kiss them all.
Do I like kissing girls? I like kissing that girl.
Yeah. Castle Point, isn't it, Rob? Yeah. Which I think is a big shopping centre.
Diner's okay, but that one's better.
Katie might still be over an hour away, but the crowd in Bournemouth has already started building, and they're hoping she'll actually make it this time.
I think last week the queue was probably a little bit bigger, but I have seen the same faces twice. So obviously people are coming back, even though she didn't turn up.
And finally, a week late, the patient people of Bournemouth get what they've been waiting for.
Katie!
And her tooth is the talk of the town.
Well, my tooth fell out. It's not really a lot I could have done.
And I gave it
to you. Oh, don't worry, we believe you.
It's your fault. I was only about 5 minutes, so I was like, oh, my God, I can't turn up like that.
It seems Katie's fans soon forgive her.
Well, I'm free.
We got here this morning.
No.
But for some, it's all too much.
I can see it, huh?
The book signing is going well, much to Mum Amy's relief.
Even on the radio coming up, we heard always she's going to turn up, isn't she? But I'm pleased that people still come out today to support her.
Not only that, but it seems Katie's training up a possible heir to her tiara.
I think because Princess sees Kate doing a lot of writing and signing, she thinks she should be doing it up there as well. So I'm surprised she's managing to keep it going, even though the kids are there.
An hour later, and Katie signs the final book in the queue of nearly 800 people, and it's a job well done.
It went really well, it's really busy. Considering I had to let them down last week because of my tooth, they're still loyal, still come back, and it's a brilliant signing. It's a brilliant day, the sun's out, we couldn't ask for more.
Phil and Gary's big day has finally arrived, and the preparations for the Midsummer Night's Dream style party are well underway. The ceremony starts in 3 hours. Across London, Katie's getting ready for the day, which will bring bittersweet memories.
This is Alex.
Hi, Alex. Good to meet you, Katie.
While she's excited Alex will be part of the official wedding party, she's also sad to be going to her first marriage ceremony since hers very publicly collapsed.
So today, it's Gary and Phil's wedding, their vows, and obviously I'm walking down the aisle with them. I'm there. I don't really know what I am.
They're a bitch.
They're a bitch. So, yeah, it'd be a good day today.
Gary's already done Katie's makeup, so now it's just down to hairstylist Nick to add the finishing touches.
Nick and me were just saying this is like a deja vu of my wedding day, because yeah, Nick done my hair for my wedding day. And I was on my own in a room. It was all silent, like, it just, yeah, it, this is really surreal.
With the record going round and round.
Yeah, we was playing the record that I'm singing at Gary's, you know, Gary and Phil's do tonight. But this really does feel very surreal, doesn't it? And knowing that I'm getting into a big, massive dress. This actually is very weird, isn't it?
Weird.
Hello.
And just like on her wedding day with Pete, Katie's best friends, Julie and Melody, will be by her side to support her.
How are you?
Well, I'm still here.
Oh,
no.
You're right.
Nice. Classy little one.
Beautiful.
With Katie getting all glammed up, Alex can hardly believe his luck.
Just
want to
be... Right, how long...
I get to go to bed with that.
With that?
Yeah. Lucky me.
Is it?
Well, lucky you, actually.
I didn't think you'd still be here. I thought you'd be long gone.
I just got a phone call. Are you all right? Are you all right?
Who from?
It's on the news that you're
History.
You've been dumped after 4 weeks. What? It's all my mates are calling me up.
No.
I'm sorry, don't care.
Are you with her?
Did you say I'm at a wedding with her today?
Yes.
Yeah,
we've got
a ride.
Brilliant,
man.
Thank you.
Down in the hotel reception, Gary and Phil are starting to get anxious.
We were supposed to leave about half an hour ago, and me and Phil obviously have to do a little run through because we don't actually know what's going to happen. So we're leaving it a bit near to the mark.
Put it on and let's see.
But back upstairs, Katie's in no hurry at all to get ready.
What? Apparently I'm bossy. Apparently.
It's an endearing quality, though.
Do you think I'm bossy?
I don't think you're bossy. I know you're
bossy.
She's
so...
She's controlling.
All right, just like, said it, all right.
She's not bossy, she's controlling.
Do you think I'm bossy?
He's a control freak.
God. Do you really think I am?
Yeah.
But I'm so not.
He even says it on your car.
In what way?
What Katie Price wants, Katie gets now.
But I don't. Who's at the door? Yeah, of course you can. I'm already playing. Don't buy it very hard.
Give him my phone.
We're going to be there. We're setting off now.
I'm going to leave this
for you. All right, bye. We're so late. We've got to go.
We're going to have to tell her that we're going.
But just as Katie's about to get left behind, she emerges in the nick of time.
Why not? Let the boys out. Come on.
Before heading straight into a paparazzi feeding frenzy, fueled by today being her first public outing with Alex.
Stop pushing me.
Close that door. Close that door. Don't touch the car. Not your car. Do not touch the car.
Crazy world of Katie Price. Coming up, Alex proves a hit at the wedding.
I hear all the ladies are after you, Alex.
I can't help it. I'm drop dead gorgeous.
Katie steals centre stage. Before reality hits home.
I felt that I was a failure, because when you marry somebody, you marry them for life. And mine wasn't for life.
It's 4 years since Katie's own wedding, and today she's facing the daunting prospect of walking down the aisle again. She's maid of honour at Gary and Phil's £200,000 fairy tale party to renew their wedding vows. But despite the serene surroundings, Katie's feeling nervous ahead of what's bound to be an emotional day.
I've got to walk down that fucking aisle. Oh my God, that's beautiful.
To try and reduce her anxiety, the Master of Ceremonies talks Katie through the order of service.
You're going to go down the aisle on your own.
And then we're
going to
follow you.
Oh my, I'm fucking
And up. When you get to the bottom, when you get to the bottom, there'll be a seat ready for you to sit down. You just take a seat, which is when you go.
Yeah, so we walk down together,
right,
yeah?
Yeah?
And then we stand, just wait there, yeah?
And then you stand.
Shitting it.
Don't shit it, it's cold, it's going to be cold.
All right.
No, I'm just thinking about everything.
Yeah?
I'm just singing, no. You're getting nervous.
Oh my God, I'm so excited. Now seeing it.
While the wedding party gets change, the guests arrive, and the anticipation builds. With a nervous Katie waiting in the wings, the stage for the magical wedding is set by unicorns, frolicking pixies, giant swans and mystical fauns, spreading fairy dust amongst the guests. And with the storybook scene set, a reflective Katie kicks off the service by walking down the aisle in her designer wedding dress. But this time, there's no husband waiting. As the ceremony starts, it's a poignant moment for Katie. It's only a year ago since she renewed her own wedding vows to Pete in a marriage she thought would last forever.
Be faithful to him alone and be true to you through good times and bad.
Gary and Phil have exchanged their vows, and now it's time for Katie to hand over the rings.
I give you this ring as the pledge of my love.
I give you this ring as the pledge of my love.
And as the symbol of our unity.
And as the symbol of our unity.
Gary and Phil have tied the knot. But no wedding is complete without a good old sing song.
Beautiful women, all these beautiful dresses.
It's Alex's first high-profile occasion as Katie's new boyfriend, and it seems he's making his mark.
See, Alex, it looks like all the ladies are after him. And he's mine. I hear all the ladies are after you, Alex.
Yeah. I can't help it, I'm drop-dead gorgeous.
Do you really think you are?
No, I don't think so.
What, oh my God, you said that on camera. Do you think you're gorgeous?
Will you tell me I'm gorgeous every 5 seconds?
You are. You're good wearing it.
You're even more gorgeous.
Sorry, you've got a hold of dummy as well.
I'm not surprised in a £50,000 dress.
And Katie's feelings for Alex are underlined by him being invited to be part of the official wedding photos.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, you guys were amazing.
Thank you.
You're very comfortable. I know you're emotional, but you're just so
Alex, zip
it. It's the most fun wedding I think I've ever been to. Really entertaining. Different.
Do you want to Jerry and Phil behind?
And Alex? Yeah, get in.
Get in the middle of it. This is a bit controversial, isn't it?
But how's Alex feeling about Katie singing later?
Well, I've heard it like about 50,000 times. So I am looking forward to it. I mean, I am, seriously. I'm also looking forward to it being over.
With all wedding formalities over, everyone can start to relax, except Katie, who's worried her emotions might get the better of her if she sings tonight.
But I'm not confident enough.
Why? You've got to.
I don't feel confident enough.
Yeah, you've got to.
I'm not being
You've got to.
Before Katie makes the decision, she slips off for a costume change. But it's a tight squeeze.
Katie, put on white.
I know I've put on weight! I told you I can't wear it!
It's beauty.
Right, Kate.
Ladies and gentlemen, health and beauty bonus.
How many men does it take to get Katie Price into bed?
That's the question.
You tell us.
I mean,
right.
Is it pulled up?
Yeah, I knew you'd be coming in here.
Is it done up?
Yeah.
The tightest ever?
As tight as it can be. Together.
Yeah, the tight better.
While the battle with the dress continues, Gary and Phil kick off the evening reception. Katie arrives just in time for the toast to the maid of honour. And while the guests savour the wedding breakfast, they're serenaded by professional singers. Heaping pressure on Katie, who's anxious about singing the final song of the night. Nerves are getting the better of her, but hopefully nothing a glass or two of champagne can't fix.
She was so nervous because we had so many amazing singers tonight. I mean, so many brilliant singers. And she was like, kept coming up and going, I don't know if I can do it, Gary. I don't know if I can do it against all these professional singers. I'm like, well, you just do what you want to do.
As drinks flow, memories of her own wedding come flooding back. Brother Dan worries singing the final song could push her over the edge.
It's really emotional for her at the moment with everything that's going on. I think it's right that she does not sing the song tonight because I think after just a few words, because it means so much to her that she will be upset. And as much as she wants to deliver to her friends Gary and Phil on their day, it's not right for her to do it today. You know? Tonight's not the night. That's the night. But she can do it. She can deliver. But not tonight.
Despite what Big Brother says, Katie steals her raw emotions with some Dutch courage.
Hello!
But determined to keep her promise to sing, she ditches the emotional ballad Heaven, opting for a more familiar track.
Can you turn the mic on loud now?
The song she walked down the aisle to with Pete.
Right, play it, hurry up! Right. Oh, I'll be good. Dancing!
We are gonna.
Get on the carpet.
Wait!
No. After composing herself, she's encouraged to take centre stage.
Go, girl.
And after a false start, Katie soon hits the high notes. Katie's got through the song and Gary's relieved it's all over.
I was actually really shocked and quite surprised about it because that was actually a wedding thing when she walked down the aisle to, so I was a little bit taken back about that. I didn't really expect that. So I was a bit like, whoa. But she did it amazingly and she broke down and it was all a bit teary. And maybe she needed to do that. I think maybe she did.
It's been a long and emotional day, giving Katie the chance to reflect on her own marriage.
Well, I know it was very up and down, emotional. I don't know why. I don't know. I think I said to my mum, my friend, that I was a failure because it's a wedding. I felt that I was a failure at a wedding because when you marry somebody, you marry them for life, and mine wasn't for life. And I tried to be the best that I could, and it wasn't right. So I just thought I was a failure, but, you know, there's so many people who get married again and again and again, and I know I'm going to get married again.
Next week...
It's like being in a goldfish bowl, this is.
Katie tries to step out of the limelight.
Sorry, can I just deal with my kids, please?
To spend some quality time with Alex...
Stop giving them the shot.
Like, what
we're
supposed to do.
And the kids.
It's male bonding.
We're not looking at the kids. We're looking at Alex.
Dad steps in to help move the press.
Do you know, I think that works.
And Katie plays the dutiful girlfriend.
Shit, I think as the night's getting on, they're getting a bit more brutal. Shit.
Oh, I love that. Do it again. Oh, yeah. Oh, all right, Alex, watch it.
Muru, somebody's calling your names.
Yeah.
Let's all have a cry about it, shall we? Or shall we take it on the chin like a man?
Katie Brand's Big Ass Show next on ITV2.